You know, there's a lot of things I don't know. Like, I don't know why ear hair is the fastest growing thing on the planet. I don't know what they put in the filling in Twinkies that makes it so good. I don't know why Shania Twain won't return my calls. But there's one thing I do know. If you want to improve your landscape photography, include some foreground interest in your photos. Okay, if you're anything like me, you'd love to get outside, take your camera with you, and take advantage of the amazing landscapes that we have here in Arizona. Right here is a perfect example. See this hill that comes down right here? It's got a bunch of saguaros on it, and it's a mountain. And you gotta take a picture of a mountain. They're just not everywhere. So what we're gonna do here, what normally people would do is they'd come out here, and they'd frame up their shot. You can turn the camera on first. Frame up your shot and squeeze. What I like to do, the reason I picked this hill is I like the way the saguaros are kind of silhouetted on the top, and I like the way the hill comes down. So I kind of frame it up so that comes about halfway through the frame. I shoot another one of those. But I'm using such a wide lens. This is an 11 to 16 millimeter lens. It's really wide. And it's great for landscape photography because you get a bunch of stuff in your photo. But if you look at the photo I just took, it looks okay. It's a mountain, but it really doesn't have much appeal and doesn't really scream off the page or off the screen to you and say, wow, that's cool. So, what we need to do is we need to include some foreground interest in the photo to give it some scale, to understand, to portray to your viewers just how cool that mountain is. So, let's just move a little bit. Okay, all we've done is we've moved about 20 feet from where we were just standing. And there is a giant, giant saguaro cactus standing here. So what we're going to do is we're going to incorporate it into our shot to help give it some scale, to let the viewer know and be able to appreciate the mountain in the background and the cool sky that's going on. We've got some clouds coming in here, and it's about an hour or so before sunset, but the clouds are got a lot of different shades of blue and white and purple, and so we're going to include that in the shot. So the foreground interest is the cactus. So keep it on the right third, left third, wherever it is, however you want to frame your shot, but keep it on one third or the other and make it look something like that. Now you can clearly see the difference in those two shots when you put them side by side is they both have the mountain in it. They both have the slope of the hill, which is kind of cool. They both have the sky and everything's in there, but the adding the foreground just of this giant saguaro cactus right here just makes it a better photo, I think. So try that when you're out shooting photographs. Include some foreground interest in your shots, and they'll just look a heck of a lot better. All right, I'm heading back to the truck because I've got another Twinkie in there that's hollering at me. So you guys get out and take some pictures. I'll see you. Oh, I should probably check my phone. Maybe Shania Twain called back.